Republican Senator Lindsey Graham expressed concern about the White House strategy on Syria following a classified briefing. Listen.
Everything in that briefing made me more worried, not less. This makes no sense to me. I am very unnerved by what I hear and what I see. And I think President Trump's been a good commander in chief. But when it comes to Syria, I think he's going down a very dangerous path.
That comes as lawmakers work on a new authorization for the use of military force against terror groups, including those in the Middle East. Republican Senator Bob Corker is the chairman of the Foreign Relations Committee and co-sponsor of that new AUMF, and he joins us now. Good morning, Senator.
Good morning. Good to be with you.
Good to have you. Did you share Senator Graham's feelings of being unnerved after that briefing that you got from Secretary of Defense Mattis?
No, not really. I thought Mattis did a great job. The administration is clear they're not going to stay to help shape what's happening on the ground in Syria against Assad, Russia, and Iran. They've been clear for a long time. We basically gave the country to Russia and Iran 3 or 4 years ago when we invited them out over the chemical weapons issue. They've taken it. They have defense mechanisms. Uh-huh. Where I think the administration, we need to be a little concerned, is over what they're doing against ISIS and talking about taking the 2,200 troops we have out too quickly there. Fortunately, Mattis intervened when the White House said they were leaving quickly, and we're not going to do that. We're going to stay behind the SDF that we have there and support the Kurds that are doing the fighting for us on the ground.
Because I'm wondering if you can also help clear something up.
Okay.
There are reports that Secretary of Defense Mattis was pushing for congressional approval for whatever was going to happen with Syria and that strike on Syria. But then there are conflicting reports about that. Do you know if that's what Secretary Mattis wanted?
I don't. And who knows whether he wanted it because he felt like it was the constitutional way of going or whether he just felt like that Congress should have some buy-in. I thought what the president did was appropriate in that regard. I did a surgical strike. I told him that on Thursday morning when he called before the attack. But look, we've had no strategy in Syria. Our nation has not had a strategy in Syria for a long time. One of the lowest moments in my foreign relations career here was when they crossed the red line in 2013 in August, and we did nothing. The opposition had momentum. It was at a time when it would have made a huge difference. And instead, we invited Russia in, and of course, they've taken the country over. The strategy for us and all Western nations has been terrible in Syria, but today it would take almost our entire military to really try to shape things on the ground. So where I'm concerned is that we leave too soon before we've done the complete job with ISIS. And as you know, Turkey is really making life miserable for us and certainly for those Kurds who've given 4,000 lives to fight the fight for us, if you will, against ISIS.
And so that leads us to your push for the new authorization for the use of military force. So what is your concern? Are you concerned just about, as you said, fighting ISIS in Syria, or that you want to be involved in whatever happens? Let's say Assad uses another chemical attack on his people, that Congress needs to be involved before the president acts.
So this AUMF would really be to replace the 01 and 02 AUMFs and would have nothing whatsoever regarding the fight against the Syrian regime if one were to occur. That would take a new AUMF. So this is only relative to our fight against al-Qaeda, the Taliban, and ISIS. Many people here have cried out for years that we need to weigh in again, that we need a new AUMF. I agreed with President Obama when he said he had all the authorities he need. I agree with President Trump that the 0102 give them legal standing to pursue these terrorists. But as chairman of the Foreign Relations Committee, I'm trying to, you know, adhere to the fact that there are people who want to weigh in, and so I've crafted something with Tim Kaine and Jeff Flake and other members of the committee, Coons, Nelson, many people that have been involved in co-sponsoring. But we've crafted, Todd Young, we've crafted something that I think strikes a middle ground that hopefully can attract Republicans and Democrats, that doesn't constrain the president's ability to fight terror, but does keep Congress involved when we go to new countries, when we add new groups. Look, it's going to be tough. People act like they want to weigh in on these issues, and then it feels like to me can find in cases every excuse possible to not be for it.
And why is that, Senator? Why is that? The rubber meets the road, they back off. Why are you meeting resistance, and what's that about?
Sure. You know, look, we're in a hyper-partisan environment. You know that well. It's just like with the Pompeo confirmation that we're underway with. You know, Democrats, I'm not being pejorative. I'm not criticizing. I'm just observing that they feel like any support for a qualified Secretary of State, which Mike Pompeo is, in my opinion, is really showing proxy support for Trump, and they don't want to be in that position. Republicans, in some cases, that might push back against the AUMF, they may feel that it looks like it's constraining the president's power, which it is not. But look, we're in a hyper-partisan place. If you remember, Secretary Clinton and Secretary Kerry both received 94 votes to be Secretary of State. It happened quickly. Mm-hmm. Mike Pompeo served in the House, has been the CIA director that many of them have worked with and, mm-hmm. and lavished praise on. But, you know, it's going to be a tight vote.
Huh. I want to get to some news of the morning. Our Manu Raju is reporting about President Trump's reelection bid that he has announced. Do you support today President Trump for re-election in 2020?
Look, who knows whether President Trump's even going to run.
He's announced that he is going to run.
Well, now, surely CNN is not taking for face value everything that comes out of the White House all of a sudden.
But wait a second. Shouldn't we trust the president when he says he's running for re-election?
I have no idea whether the president runs for re-election, nor what the field will be on the Republican side. So I think it's way too early to weigh in on who one might support.
But are you saying that you're not sure that President Trump is going to run?
Oh, I'm definitely not sure he's going to run.
He's raised $4 million.
Well, I mean, $4 million is a speck of sand in the ocean as it relates to these kind of things, and you know that. So, look.
Let me just say this.
Any president that's 18 months into their term or 15 or 16 or 17, whatever it is likely to say that they're going to run for re-election. They do not want to be viewed as a lame duck. I take it with a grain of salt. It's just another thing going across the internet.
Okay, here's what I'm getting at. If he is the nominee, will you support him?
Again, if he's the nominee, you mean he's won the primary?
If he runs for re-election, are you going to support him?
Well, I want to know who else is in the field. Do you know who you're going to support on the Democratic side?
What makes you think that I will support someone on the Democratic side, Senator?
I don't know.
Senator, the point is you are a Republican. This is your president. This is the leader of your party, the leader of our country.
I have no idea. Yeah, I know. But look, we're going to burn time. We could be talking about other things. I have no idea who's going to run for president in 2020. And I'm not about to say who I would support for that. So we have no idea who's going to run. Whether the president runs again or not, I think is very questionable, candidly.
Why wouldn't he?
I don't know. Why would he?
Because he likes being president of the United States.
He might. He might not. Who knows? But look, when it comes time, ask me that question. When we know that for real papers have been filed and we know who the field is, I'd be more than glad to come forward, as I always do, and tell you what I think.
Okay. We'll hold you to that. That's a date, Senator Bob Corker. Thank you very much for being with us this morning.
Thank you.